Rebbe had a chassid by the name Reb Baruch. Reb Baruch was once called to the minister of his town. And the minister said to him, I need you to become the manager of the government's lumber yard. The government's lumber yard? What do I have to do with the government? Well, but they also have wood underneath, so the iron doesn't sink into the ground. And these woods have to be very special and strong. So we need you to be in charge of the lumber yard. And you'll get paid 100 ruble a week. That was a lot of money. He said, on one condition, that Friday afternoon, like 2 hours before Shabbos or more, I can go home and not work on Shabbos. He said, okay. And he took the job and he was very careful. Whenever they took these woods to make more tracks for the railroad, he always kept a list. Who took it, how much money they paid, and the government was very, very happy with the work of Reb Baruch. Now in that town, there lived a big troublemaker. He was Yevan, a guy who always made trouble with everyone. Yevan was very jealous. Why did the minister give the job to Baruch? Yevan used to be the one in charge. Yevan used to take care of the lumber yard. But the government sent him away. You know why? Because he always made trouble. Customers would come, he would pick a fight. Whoever Yevan would talk with, he was able to start a fight with the cockroach. He was just a guy who loved to fight. And the government sent him away, and they took Baruch instead. Now, to do such a thing made Yevan very jealous and angry. And he says, I'm gonna take revenge. Now Reb Baruch, the chassid of the Alter Rebbe, did not know that Yevan is planning a plot against him. What did he do? In the middle of the night, when everyone was asleep, Yevan brought a wagon to the lumberyard, and he snuck in, and he took 20 logs from the lumberyard that belongs to the government and put him on his wagon and brought these logs to the backyard of Reb Baruch's house and put them into his garage. The next morning, Yevan went to the minister and said, huh, you think Baruch is so honest? Come and I'll show you what he did. And he brings him to the backyard of Baruch's house, says, look what Baruch did. He stole 20 logs. You're sure he did it? Yeah, look, it's right here. And he goes into the garage and he sees there are 20 logs there and they are from the lumberyard. He recognized it. The minister got so angry. Oh, Baruch is gonna get punished. Really, really punished for this. But I'm warning you, Yevan, if it turns out that he's not guilty, your life is worthless. The next thing, Baruch gets a letter in the mail from the minister that you are to appear in the minister's office this Tuesday morning, 8 o'clock. And if you don't come 8 o'clock in the morning, you will be paying the biggest punishment that the law will require. Reb Baruch got this letter and he was shocked. He didn't know what to do. He showed it to his wife, and his wife also was shocked. He said, what do we do? Well, the first thing we do, you have a tachanin Hashem. Hashem will surely help. but they wanted me to come in 2 days from now. Well, listen, you know what we can do? Can I ask that? So Baruch went and traveled, went to the Alter Rebbe, who lived not far from him. And it was he got there Sunday, it was near Sunday afternoon. And he said to the Rebbe, look at the letter I got. And the Alter Rebbe looked at it, and it says there, you must come 8 o'clock Tuesday morning. And if you don't come, you're going to get punished to the fullest extent of the law. The Alter Rebbe thought for a while, and he looks up and he says, Baruch, come back to me next week, Sunday, and I'll give you instructions what to do. And Baruch left, and he's all puzzled. I wanted to know if I should go in 2 days to the minister's office, and the Rebbe tells me, come next week. That means I'm going to skip the appointment. I'm going to miss the appointment. But on the paper it said that I can get punished. He came home and his wife said, you look so puzzled. What's going on? Says, the Rebbe told me not. I should come to him next week. Did the Rebbe tell you to go in 2 days from now? No. Did he tell you to go on Tuesday morning 8 o'clock? No. Then you're not going. But what's going to be about the punishment? Do you think that if someone listens to the Rebbe, anything can go wrong? You listen to the Rebbe and that's it. The following Sunday, he came to the Alter Rebbe. And when he came to the Alter Rebbe looked at him with a big smile and said, because of your good deeds and your strong bitachon in Hashem, everything is going to be all right. Yes, Tuesday morning, 8 o'clock, you can go and visit the minister. In 2 days from now, you should go. Tuesday morning, 8 o'clock. Yes, go to the appointment. And everything will be just fine. The Baruch left the Alter Rebbe. Now he's again puzzled. I'm supposed to go last week to Tuesday morning, not this week. And the Rebbe knows that. And the Rebbe did not tell me to go last week, he told me now. So he came home and told his wife, and his wife said, Baruch, who is the man managing the world? Who is in charge of the world? The minister? No, Hashem. We trust in Hashem. We have faith in Hashem, and Hashem is going to help us. Because whenever you have bitachin, Hashem always helps. Hashem says, just trust in me. I'm going to sing the song, and then I'm going to continue to finish the story. I believe in Hashem, I trust in Hashem. There never is a moment when that I am alone and I'm on my own. I believe and I trust in Hashem, because I understand that He's holding my hand, and every step is perfectly planned. He's holding me tight, so I'll be alright. I believe and I trust in Hashem. So when Reb Baruch thought about it, the next Tuesday morning, he made his way to the minister's office. A week late. Can you imagine a week late? And he was warned on the paper, on the invitation. It said, you come late, you get punished. But he's not afraid. Who's in charge? Hashem. And the Rebbe told him to come this Tuesday, not last Tuesday. When you listen to the Rebbe, everything will go right. He came to the minister's office, and the guard in front of the office sees Reb Baruch. He says, Rabbi, you're here? The minister is looking for you. He wants to see you. So he goes inside, then the minister jumps from his seat and he gives a big handshake to Reb Baruch with a big smile. Oh, Rabbi, I'm so happy that you came. I'm so happy that you're alive. I'm so happy to see you.
Murrah is completely confused now, what's going on? And the governor, the minister said, let me tell you what happened. You know, Yvonne brought me to the back of your house and showed me the 20 logs. And he told me that you're the one who stole them. Guess what happened? I was so angry at you, Baruch. I wanted to give you the biggest punishment, but I wasn't sure what should that be. So I sent a message to the Russian government, and I told them to decide what kind of punishment you deserve for stealing the logs from the government. And you know what they decided? They sent an officer with a gun to stand by my office Tuesday morning last week Tuesday morning, 8 o'clock, an officer was standing there with a gun, and that's why I told you that you must come Tuesday morning, 8 o'clock. You thought you're coming for an appointment. You were coming just to get shot. And for some strange reason, you did not come. And guess what happened? 2 days later, on Thursday, two witnesses came to me and said, we saw Yvonne stealing the logs from the lumberyard and putting them in Baruch's backyard just to get him in trouble. Oh, I was so happy you didn't come Tuesday morning, because I see that the troublemaker was actually Yvonne. I can promise you, you don't have to worry about Yvonne anymore. He's taken care of. And you go back to your job, and I'm gonna give you extra money for your work. Reb Baruch came home and he said, look what happened here. I was threatened by the minister. I was threatened by the government that if I don't come the way they say, I'm gonna get in trouble. But the Rebbe told me to go next week to him. You know, if we listen to the Rebbe, even if everything looks the opposite, the Rebbe has eyes and he sees the truth. Through the Rebbe's eyes, everything is different than the way we look at it. If he would have listened to his Yetzer Hara, if he would have listened to his anxiety, and if he would have gone to the government last Tuesday, by the original appointment, he wouldn't be here to tell the story. Because he listened to the Rebbe's words, his life was saved. You know, the Rebbe sees everything in a way that's emes from Hashem. The Rebbe sees that the Geula is about to come. And the Rebbe says, don't worry. Everything is going to be okay. Geula is coming. Mashiach is coming. Any moment, just get ready. And we look around, we see, galus. So many Yvans roaming around and troubles and this and that. Let's ignore that and listen to the holy words of the Rebbe, Higi Hazman Geulaschem. And the Rebbe told us what we should do, how to get ready. The Rebbe said, we should get ready for the Geula by... that when we learn in Yana Geula Mashiach every day, that's going to open our eyes and we are going to start seeing the Geula unfold in front of us. The Rebbe said, this is Derech HaYashara, the quickest way to bring the Geula. And that's why, since we're now on Simchas Beis HaSheva, and we're going to be besimcha, we're going to dance, and we're going to bring so much simcha, it's going to bring so many brachas. Any moment now, the music will be ready. And I want to tell you something that the Rebbe said many times. It says in Zohar that there's a certain gate in heaven that brings blessings, it brings brachas. The gate in heaven opens up when you are smiling, when you are happy. And if things are not going the way we want, smile. Be happy, dance, and the gates will open, and all the blessings, all the brachas are going to come. And that's why, that's what we got to do now. We have the days that the Rebbe tells us is the strongest time to bring the Ula. That we should be able to dance in the days, Hamikdash HaShlishi, the courage, Mamash. Zayt Kizot, and thank you that women should be on the other side of the barricade, and we should get ready for dancing. A good yantiv, and a good mayeng, and a good yar, and thanks to Rabbi Yisrael Shem Tov, you should be gesund and stark for the next kind incident to continue making us happy with the simcha, and thank you everyone who's organizing this night on the gesund. Every night there's going to be simcha specifically here. There's going to be special programs, and you can tune in and find out the posters exactly at the time. Zayt Kizun.
Good. 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 Yeah. standing over there? Stand next to Shmuley. Shmuley. Shmuley.
Oh, Oh, Hey, hey. Oh, Oh, Thank you. Moshiach Tzidkin, you love us come swiftly towards us, he may believe in our destiny. There will be no more war, no more the lines roll, no more the heart of the day, with a mix of the fame, what we face to his name, that will march to you, know with the living sleeve. There will be no more war, no more the lines roll, no more the heart of the day, with a mix of the fame, what we face to his name, that will march to you, know with the living sleeve. From the dream of colors, campaigning to greet Moshiach Tzidkin, you and I come swiftly towards our scene name zone. Ah, ha, 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 no more war, no more the lines roll, no more the heart is there, yo. We're on the stoop of flame, we'll give thanks to his name. Half a march, we'll give you go with the devish. Leave the level, we'll be no more war.
Yeah. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Yeah, you're the Oh, Thank you. La 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 Yeah. La 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 Do we have to wait? Para que se Thank you. Oh,
See, young lady, boy, so.